Sarah Kate, tell me about your journey as a semi-finalist, as a finalist, and just some advice and tips you could give to possible finalists for next year.
Oh, journey, it's just been such an incredible journey, and I hate the word pageant because it really isn't a pageant, as you know. This is a woman empowerment movement that we actually are. Women that are wives, that are mothers, that are career women. And just meeting like-minded women and being inspired by these other women and hearing their stories and their life lessons and the journeys that life has taken them through has just been so inspirational, and it makes me even more honored to be the winner out of such a strong group of women. So my advice to the women that are going to be entering is just really be yourself. You know, your past does not define you. It's part of your journey, and it's part of what the inspiration of your life story is actually going to be. And don't try and be anything else other than yourself, because you're only going to disappoint yourself in the long run. But whatever you're bringing to the pageant with your heart is what you're going to be doing for your year of reign.
Who do you think is Mrs. South Africa?
Me. I think Mrs. South Africa is a real woman. She needs to be relatable. Women must want to walk up to her and engage with her and find out more about her. So really, the She Is Bona Fide campaign, I believe, is just absolutely exceptional. And it really is the foundation of what this journey is.
You are a mom of two little boys. Your youngest is only 10 months old.
Yes.
And you're also the owner of a successful company in your own business. Can you do it all? How are you doing it all? And what would your advice be?
You can do it all, but you do need a good support structure. So my advice is that tell your husband that you're going to enter and have a family discussion about it. If it's going to be with your husband or if you have older kids, you know there are going to be some days that you're doing a charity event during the semi-finals and the finals, not even as the winner. You're going to be going out and campaigning for yourself. So make sure you have a support structure and that your family's all on the same page, where mommy's going to be a little bit busier or mommy's going to be doing a little bit more outside of what the normal family home is in the current situation.
Tell me, what has the title meant to you so far? You've only been crowned about a month ago, but what does it mean to you, and what has it, you know, has it opened doors for you?
Oh my gosh, I was just about to say it has flung doors of opportunities open for me. Never in my wildest dream did I think that I would be going to the events and meeting the people, the caliber of people that I'm meeting. It really is from people in government right down to people that, you know, don't even have a loaf of bread, and the difference that you can make with this title. Truly, there is a power in a title, in a sash, in a crown, and it's what you do with that that is just life-changing, and the honor of being able to change lives is just, I'm beyond honored. I'm so humbled by this.
And then Sarah Kate, you've won obviously the title now, but I think the message that we need to get across is that these finalists take so much more
absolutely
out of the pageant, the growth and the whole journey and what you as a woman gain out of this whole experience.
Journey, what I think you've done different and what sets this pageant apart is that you invest so much personal energy into every single woman. You get to know them and you obviously keep your professional distance. But every single woman that comes through this process is leaving a better version of themselves. And that's the gift that you give every single one of us, irrespective of if you win or not. And even backstage, just before I actually was crowned, I was actually just reflecting on all the moments of all the workshops. It's a woman empowering movement that you're actually creating here. And I just want to remind the semi-finalists and the finalists, go into this knowing that there's only going to be one winner. But go into this knowing that you are a mover and a shaker in society as a wife, as a mother, as a career woman. So take whatever you can from this experience and apply it to your life.
Fantastic. We wish you the best of luck for Mrs. World coming up in just about 2 months. And we are very excited about it, and we're sure you're going to do us so proud.
I hope so.
You will.